It's a battle between union concessions from thousands and saving the jobs of hundreds. Abe Lubetkin is here with a story new at 10. Abe, this is turning into a blame game.
Hey, Kathy, this starts with massive cuts to education in the state budget. As a result, MPS says it had to lay off staff. Now, the district says if teachers would reopen their contracts, which don't expire until 2013, and agree to pay more for their pensions, the district could avoid some of those layoffs. Right now, hundreds of teachers are caught in the middle.
Today, I actually did reach out again to our union partners, and we've been unable to connect. So
MPS Superintendent Gregory Thornton wants to connect with the district's teacher union to talk about greater pension contributions. Thornton says 200 teachers could keep their jobs if all teachers agreed to pay 5.8% of their pensions. This week, 514 district staff, including 354 teachers, got layoff notices.
I was expecting it, but there was still a little bit of hope that I wouldn't receive it.
First grade teacher Melissa Grunewald says her union is in a tough spot.
I think it's a difficult situation because they do need to support their members. We have already given up concessions.
She worries about the quality of education diminishing.
I know that the class sizes will get much larger. The students will not have gym, art, music, so they're not really getting what they need out of the school.
It's devastating. You feel for the kids the most.
Laid-off teacher Joe Brusky points out Milwaukee teachers did agree to concessions, which the union says will save the district $94 million over 2 years.
And it's hard because $800 million have been cut from public education, and I think that's kind of what's driving this, not necessarily the greed of teachers.
And certainly, I do acknowledge all the support that they provided earlier on in the initial contract, but a lot's changed. I think we all would acknowledge that.
And in a nutshell, you'd like them to make more concessions?
In a nutshell, I would like to have that conversation. Hopefully, will lead to potentially more concessions, and that will lead to more classroom teachers, and that will lead to certainly better opportunities for young people.
Now, while the district wants to resolve this sooner rather than later, they say they could remain open to union concessions even after the start of the school year. Now, Kathy, we left multiple calls today for the Milwaukee Teachers Union, but they never called us back.
All right. Thank you, Abe.